Planet Earth is truly ancient. For a half a billion years, there is no life on Earth whatsoever. During an eon known as the Archaean, the first simple cells occur. Oxygen is added to the atmosphere as blue-green algae perform photosynthesis. And in an eon known as the Proterozoic, more complex cells known as eukaryotic cells are known. By the end of the Proterozoic, animals are known. Most of the fossil history of macroscopic animals is confined to the Phanerozoic eon. Animal life begins at the end of the Proterozoic eon and diversifies during the Ediacaran period. But most of animal history occurs only in the Phanerozoic eon, the last half billion years. We split this Phanerozoic eon into three eras: the Paleozoic, or old life, the Mesozoic, or middle life, and the Cenozoic, for more recent life. These eras, the Paleozoic, Mesozoic, and Cenozoic eras, can then be divided into periods. So the Paleozoic era can be split into the Cambrian period, where the first fish and diverse arthropods evolve, the Ordovician and Silurian periods, where the first jawed fish evolve, the Devonian period, where the first amphibians evolve, the Carboniferous for the first reptiles, and the Permian. The end of the Permian is marked by the worst mass extinction in Earth's history. This is when more than 90% of life dies out to end the Paleozoic era. The Mesozoic era begins with the Triassic period, which witnesses the first dinosaurs and mammals. The first birds and flowering plants evolve in the Jurassic period. And the Cretaceous period marks the end of the Mesozoic era. A mass extinction at the end of the Cretaceous dooms the dinosaurs. The last 65 million years are known as the Cenozoic era. This is also known as the Age of Mammals because after the demise of the dinosaurs, mammalian lineages have been able to diversify, and the groups of modern organisms have reached the state we see today.